Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Tara. I'm a self-taught fashion designer and the owner of the brand Marie Elaine, which focuses on custom designs for women. You can follow me at By Marie Elaine and also at Shop By Marie Elaine. And in the description below, I'm going to leave my blog site, which is bymarieelaine.com. Now, the purpose of this channel is that I've been sewing for 11 years now, and I believe that I've acquired enough skill and expertise to share with others. So anybody that's learning to sew, that wants to learn to sew, become a fashion designer, I'll be sharing tips, tricks, DIYs, designs, the design process, anything to do with fashion, it will be here on this blog. So stay tuned, subscribe. If you're interested, like, share, comment, and let me know what you think. So the purpose of this video is, as a new sewer, there are a lot of things I wish I knew when I was just learning. So the top 10 things I wish I knew when learning to sew are, firstly, needle size and type. I didn't know that different fabrics require different needles and sizes. And I was sewing everything with one needle, and sometimes it would work, sometimes it wouldn't work out, and I had no clue why. The second thing I wish I knew was needle tension. I didn't know that stitches could be too tight or too loose. But if it's too tight, it's going to gather. If it's too loose, you'll see the separation in the seams. I have a few things written down here, so don't mind me looking down every now and then. I'm new to this, bear with me. The third thing I wish I knew was measure twice and cut once. It is so important to have your measurements accurate. Like, you don't want to waste good fabric. So you want to ensure that you measure your client properly, or if you're making something for yourself, just measure. If it takes a lot of time, I know it's frustrating, you have to be patient, but measure twice, cut once. The fourth thing I wish I knew when learning to sew is that not all fabrics are the same. I didn't realize that sheer fabrics needed to be handled differently from knit fabrics, which are stretchy, and also woven fabrics, which are non-stretchy, like cotton or linen. So, you know, it was a whole learning experience, knowing that you have to think about all of these things. The fifth thing that I wish I knew when learning to sew is that garments need to be lined. It depends on the type of garment that you're doing, but most garments, if you want a nice finished look, it's going to be lined. Even swimsuits are lined, because you don't want to be seeing your bra, your panty, unless that's the intended, you know, if that's the intention of the designer, fine, or the outfit. But certain things need to be lined, especially like gowns. Gowns have to be lined. The sixth thing I wish I knew when I was learning to sew is to press all my seams. Press, press, press. You need to press your seams. I've seen at times people are sewing and they make certain garments and the seams aren't pressed. And you can tell, because you'll notice a little wave sometimes in the garment and it looks, you know, bulky. It doesn't look flat. It doesn't lay on the body. You have to press your seams. You have to sew your seams together and press your seams together. Press your seams out. The seventh thing I wish I knew when learning to sew is to use muslin or scrap fabric. Especially if you're testing out a new design, you need to practice. You need to make sure that this is exactly what you're going to do, because you don't want to waste fabric, you don't want to waste money, you don't want to waste time. So it's important to make a prototype. This is something like I used to feel like, okay, I've been doing this for a while, I don't need to make no prototype. Yes I do. And it works out better for me, and I can also use that prototype as an example to, you know, make something else in the future. So it's not a waste of time. It saves you time, actually. The eighth thing I wish I knew when learning to sew is that the preparation time before you actually start sewing is time consuming. So you have to take your measurements, you have to draft your pattern, you have to cut out your muslin fabric or scrap fabric, and then you have to cut out the actual fabric, and then you have to pin it together before you actually go to the sewing machine to sew the garment. So sewing is the easy part. It's the preparation that takes time, and I wasn't really aware that, you know, sewing takes time. You know, you have to be patient. The ninth thing I wish I knew when learning to sew is that the seam ripper will be my best friend. You're gonna make mistakes, or I made mistakes, and I had to pull out seams. It was very frustrating. I would always get kind of angry and be like, oh, I can't do this because I have to pull out stitches. But it's okay. It's good to, you know, learn from your mistakes. It's good to have to pull out some stitches, because you're not gonna wanna make the mistake again, because you don't wanna sit down and pull out all the stitches in a garment just to put them right back in. But it's worth it, so it's okay to make mistakes. The final thing that I wish I knew when learning to sew is practice. Practice, practice, practice. The more you practice, the better you'll get. Can't stress it enough. Like anything you're doing, if you wanna get better, you have to practice. So those are my top 10 things I wish I knew when learning to sew. I will be doing videos on some of the things that I mentioned in my list today. I will be sharing my designs and DIYs, like this top that I made. A little top action here. Very cute, very chic, statement sleeve. So stay tuned, stay with me. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment anything. Let me know some things that you struggle with when you were learning to sew. Ask me anything you need to know about sewing if you're just learning. Stay tuned for more. Bye.